Hello all, I'm Sandhya Kiran JK, working as Assistant Professor, Civil Engineering Department, St. Martin's Engineering College. Today we are going to discuss one of the core objectives of Civil Engineering, that is Hydrology and Water Resources Engineering. So as a civil engineer, this subjective is very important to design the irrigation and hydraulic structures like dams, reservoirs, canal regulatory works, cross regulatory works, diversion headworks and various other important irrigational projects. So now in this subject you will be learning about hydrology, wherein it is an assimilation of hydrology as well as water resources engineering. Hydrology is the science which deals with replenishment and depletion of water resources on the planet Earth. In hydrology, the basic concept of hydrological cycle and the components of hydrological cycle are dealt. Hydrological cycle deals with the process of how rainfall occurs. The rainfall occurs because of when the water bodies, huge water bodies, are exposed to the latent heat of vaporization because of the solar radiation from the sun's radiation, and because of which the latent heat of vaporization, the lighter air fronts rise up and they meet a colder warm front and they cool down at an altitude in the atmosphere and they condense to form clouds, and the clouds, after change in certain temperature, they result in the rainfall. And when rainfall is happening, there can be many components that are comprising for the calculation of the discharge. So what is this hydrological cycle components? First of all, rainfall is referred to as precipitation in hydrology, and precipitation is a form of rainfall which can be either a normal rain or it can be snow, hail or drizzle or glaze. And the other components of hydrological cycle are evaporation, evapotranspiration, and then depression storage, and it can be infiltration, it can be groundwater or base flow, and it can also be the excess amount of water that retains on the earth's surface, which is called as surface runoff. Now all the components have to be phenomenally understood, and you should be able to assess what are the factors influencing these components to either rise or decrease, to learn the cause behind the replenishment or depletion of the water resources. And also here, while dealing with these components, we need to estimate them either instrumentally or numerically. There are various methods available. For example, if I have to calculate the rainfall or precipitation, the average depth of precipitation over a catchment, there are three methods which are available, and that is arithmetic method, Thiessen-Polygon method and isohydral method. And if I have to manually measure the rainfall, then I am going to use the help of rain gauges, and the rain gauge networks will help me know how much is the rainfall. And there are other methods graphically which will help me know how much is the average depth of rainfall over a catchment. Similarly, if we look into one other component, which is the surface runoff, which is produced when after the rainfall treats all the deficiency of water in the soil, and the soil reaches to a place, a level where it attains the soil saturation, is called as infiltration. After the soil reaches the saturation, the water travels on its surface, and this surface runoff will cause even discharges, and these discharges, if they reach to a peak or if they maximize, may result in floods. So if there are concrete paved roads that are there in the cities, then we have to do storm water management for directing this runoffs. And if the flow is more than what is expected, then it has to be predicted to take some mitigation steps for the flood which has happened. and to reduce the effect of the flood. So estimating the flood is always a helpful thing to eradicate its possible ill effects. So one of the numerical method which was earlier developed when the softwares like HECRAS, that is HECRAS, is the now available model to estimate the floods, and other flood softwares like MIKE. So before these softwares were available, we have a method to calculate the flood, and one of such methods is by developing a hydrograph. What is a hydrograph? A hydrograph is a plot between discharge taken on the y-axis and time period on the x-axis. And whenever we plot a hydrograph of every particular rainfall, we will be having the maximum discharge with us. And this may be utilized for analyzing the flood which may happen. So let us come to the topic of hydrographs. And a hydrograph is a graph showing the rate of flow discharge versus time past a specific point in a river or a channel or a conduit carrying the flow. It can also be called as a graph and showing the volume of water reaching a particular outflow. And then we have these hydrographs are commonly used for design of the sewer pipes, which can be design of surface water sewerage system and the combined sewers. And then what are the components of this hydrograph? A hydrograph has the following components, like the rising limb. A rising limb of a hydrograph is also known as concentration curve. It reflects a prolonged increase in the discharge from a catchment area, typically in response to any particular rainfall. And then there is a recession limb or a falling limb, which is the recession limb extends from peak flow rate onwards, and the end of storm flow and the return to the groundwater derived base flow is taken as the point of inflection of the recession limb. And the recession limb represents the withdrawal of water from the storage built in the basin during the earlier phases of the hydrograph. So now there are other components like peak discharge, which is the highest peak point in the graph, and the lag time, it is the time interval from the center of the hydrograph to the peak of the resulting hydrograph, and time to peak is the time interval from the start of the resulting hydrograph, and the discharge is the rate of flow, that is volume per unit time passing a specific location in a river or other channel. Now this is the hydrograph we have, and the hydrograph we can see that it is having an approach segment where the rising limb is about to begin, and there are two points called X and Y, which are the points of contraflexures where the change is about to come, and this is the peak discharge point, and this is the falling limb, and here where the rainfall ceases is termed as the end point. If you join the starting point and the end point of a rainfall, we will be remaining with the base flow that has happened during the entire rainfall event. And above zone is representing the excess amount of water that had traveled on the soil surface, or this is the direct runoff which has been produced during one particular rainfall event. So that is how these components are being explained in this unit hydrograph. Next, you have unit hydrograph. In our types of hydrographs, you have unit hydrograph. A unit hydrograph is a hydrograph which represents only 1 centimeter of particular rainfall, and it is developed for any watershed or catchment to analyze the peak discharges. Now, hydrograph usually consists of a fairly regular lower portion that changes slowly throughout the year, and a rapidly fluctuating component that represents the immediate response to the rainfall. The lower, slowly changing portion is termed as base flow, and the rapidly fluctuating component is called direct runoff. So here we have a graph between time and the discharge. So here we can see it represents only 1 centimeter rainfall, and when you join the point of rise and the point of end, these two inflection points separate the rainfall, that we are remaining with the groundwater or base flow, and above it is representing the amount of direct runoff that the rainfall has produced.
Unit hydrograph is the amount of runoff resulting from either 1 unit or 1 centimeter, 1 mm, 1 feet, etc. of rainfall excess, and it is essentially a tool for determining the direct runoff response to rainfall. Once you know the watershed's response to one storm, you can predict what its response for the another. That is the reason we are using 1 centimeter as the base unit hydrograph. If a watershed's characteristic for 1 centimeter unit hydrograph can be estimated, then it can be developed further for any centimeter of rainfalls. Next is basic assumption for the unit hydrograph, and the effective rainfall is uniformly distributed within its duration. Suppose any storm whichever is occurring for any X amounts of duration, then that effective rainfall is uniformly distributed in that duration. And second assumption is that the effective rainfall is uniformly distributed over the entire drainage basin. And the base duration of the direct runoff hydrograph due to an effective rainfall of unit duration is constant. The ordinates of DRH are proportional to the total amount of direct runoff that is being produced. And for a given basin, the runoff hydrograph due to a given period of rainfall reflects all the combined physical characteristics of the basin. Now, in this direction, we have one procedure for derivation of unit hydrograph from hydrograph. This type 1, wherein derivation of unit hydrograph from given DRH we are going to do. In this, we need to utilize the equation that total hydrograph is equal to the direct runoff hydrograph plus base flow. That will give us total hydrograph. So this equation in particular you are utilizing to calculate any. So now step 1 is to compute direct runoff hydrograph, and the direct runoff hydrograph is equal to ordinates of flood hydrograph minus base flow. And step 2 is computing the unit hydrograph ordinates for 6 hours, that is ordinates of unit hydrograph equal to ordinates of TRH divided by excess rainfall. So here we are with the ordinates of unit hydrograph. How did we obtain the column 4? We have obtained it by total hydrograph ordinates minus base flow ordinates will give us direct runoff ordinates, divided by the excess runoff will give us the ordinates of unit hydrograph. Okay, so we have obtained this, and if you examine this flow, we can see that there is a peak flow, that is Q maximum, happening in this ordinates, and it is at this flow 225 that the peak discharge is happening. And also in this we have one more case, where is type 2, where in derivation of direct runoff hydrograph or flood hydrograph from given unit hydrograph is done. So this is the vice versa of the case that we have done just now, and here the ordinates of 3R unit hydrograph are given below, and assuming the base flow is 15 meter cube per second, and we need to derive the DRH for 2 cm, 6 cm and 4 cm rainfall. So how do we get it? It is when we take the column 2 and multiply it with 2, we are going to get this DRH due to 2 cm. And then when we take column 2 and multiply it with 6, we are remaining with the column 4. If you are taking the DRH to 4 cm, you need to multiply these ordinates with 4 cm, then you are going to get the DRH to 4 cm. These are the ways how we calculate the ordinates. So now we have looked into the concept of hydrology and how the basic concepts of hydrograph and unit hydrographs. We have emphasized on the equation that total unit hydrograph is the summation of direct runoff ordinates plus the base flow ordinates. That is the thing that you have learned, and you have also seen how a unit hydrograph looks like. A unit hydrograph has its own rising limb, peak discharge and the falling limb. And what is the lag time, peak time to peak and time of concentration were also seen in the graph. And these graphs are developed for any D hours, that is the duration for which
the rainfall is happening and especially for which the excess runoff has produced. So thank you, and we will meet next time with one more topic. Thank you.